Hello guys, bit of a different video today. My name is Bill Ross, I'm the director and editor of a little film called Talbot that I've been trying to make for upwards of a year and a half now. And as I recently posted on my social media, there has been a brief update obviously in the production of the film, and I thought, as I mentioned in that post, I'll go a little bit more in depth into what that actually entails, and just, you know, break it down for you and give you the information regarding the film. Now, Talbot as a film was kind of conceptualized more than a year and a half ago as my final major project for my level 3 media course, film and TV media course at college. However, I didn't really see it as a final major project per se. It was a passion project for me, or it has been, or it will be. That's why I'm still talking about it and I'm still continuing to make it instead of leaving it at the end of college. And so literally recently, on the 18th of March, it was 1 year since I shot the original footage that you see in the teaser trailers and the TV spots that I put out since that you might see on the screen right now. And that was a year ago I shot all of that. However, obviously when I was there, it was the first day of the season, so Spinball Wizard wasn't operational that day, and the Skyride, well, if you follow the updates on Talbot, you know exactly a pain in the ass as Skyride is being, but in all fairness, it does need the work. The Skyride was closed that day, so I said to myself, I will hopefully come back before the deadline comes for the college project, and I will shoot Spinball Wizard and Skyride. And I waited, and I waited, and I waited, and it got to like a week before it was due to be handed in, and I had to say to my teacher, or even had to say to me, look, you're not going to be able to go back and film it because it's obviously not opening, so just post-produce what you have and discuss it in your evaluation as to what, you know, those issues were, and it's obviously not a finished project, despite the fact that it clocked in and over, it clocked over an hour and a half, when most other people's FMPs were clocking in at 15 to 20 minutes maximum. So obviously, you know, it was more than enough to get my distinction that I did. But the film was never complete, and I said on that website, I said on all my evaluation stuff that I will, you know, it is my intention to fully finish the film, to have the film be an accurate representation of the Alton Towers experience in 2023. Which, in 2023, Alton Towers had various different things going on that are different to what is right now and what will be in the future. So, for example, the Retro Squad was there at that point in time, it's no longer there now. Nemesis was closed, it was being constructed. Nemesis Reborn at the Nemesis Subterra was not even open at the time I attended, so I couldn't include that in the film. So I also planned to go back and shoot that, because Nemesis Subterra did open, but it was way after the deadline and things like that. So, yeah, so at that time there was no Subterra, there was no Nemesis, the Retro Squad was still existing. So it was very different to what you have now, where you have, well, at the time, sorry, there was a Retro Squad. There was no Nemesis, there was no Subterra. So obviously now you have Nemesis, now you have Nemesis Subterra, now you don't have the Retro Squad, and the Skyride is still closed. So in that time, I said to myself, you know, I'll just finish it in 2023, later one day when I can find the time to go back there when the Skyride does open. And then there was a statement made by some of the Alton Towers team that the ride would not open for the rest of the 2023 season due to, you know, essential works going on. So I was like, okay, that's fair enough. I put out the same statement that I put out even more recently, saying film's been delayed to 2024, so I can actually include the Skyride. And then it was up in the air whether I would include things like Retro Squad if it was still around, or Subterra if it ever opened. And I made it clear that, you know, those things were in consideration. I was planning to shoot again in before the end of the 2023 season, but they announced that the ride would not open for this 2023 season. So I then said, okay, the film will be coming out in 2024, and I will, you know, shoot the new Nemesis will be included in the pre-existing footage, and the Subterra will be included in the pre-existing footage, so that would extend the Forbidden Valley section. Obviously, I made the decision at that point in time to say I'm going to keep the Retro Squad in because it still feels nice to have that, and it's a nice section, and, you know, as much as it's not a current at that year, it still feels more complete as a film if I kept the Retro Squad in. So I decided to keep the Retro Squad in. Obviously, Spinball Wizard and Skyride would be added in, but, you know, there's a version that exists unlisted on YouTube that has the sections for Spinball and Skyride still in there with just a blank screen saying placeholder piece skipped to this time, but the full music is there and everything, and the pictures have vaguely the effect I was going for. And so for a while it was like, oh, okay, I'll just shoot in 2024, and you know, towards this, just before the 2024 season started, so in like January, February kind of time, we saw that the Skyride station was being done up. It was starting to look nice. I was like, okay, cool, it's going to open. Do I go back early in the season? Do I wait a little bit later? I was still planning on going back perhaps middle of the year, just so operations and things could get fluid, and the Nemesis Reborn would be open at that time, so I could shoot that as well. And then Bianca Searman, the current division director of Haunted Towers, put out this statement, and also, I mean, she put out a long-winded statement on Instagram and other social media platforms, and then they made a video. However, they decided to omit the Skyride from the video for some reason, but she did have two whole slides dedicated to the fact that they did announce that the Skyride would not be opening for the rest of the 2024 season, and that's due to essential works to keep the ride operation. So this is not a video of me ranting to Haunted Towers to open the Skyride, because I understand, having done the research when making this film, that the Skyride is a very, very, very old attraction, and from what I've read during the time where I was going through Reddit and different internet sources to try and find information about if anyone knows when the Skyride was opening, I read a lot of things, people saying that the ride was at that time when it closed in a condition that was basically inoperable. You couldn't operate the ride, and it was very, very like health and safety unfit to be used. It was not in the best condition, having deteriorated over the last 15 plus years since the last time they did it up. So I can understand why. Here's hoping that when it does come back in 2025, it'll be fully refitted, it'll look amazing. Hell, I would like to see some new cars, because I feel like we have that time scale where the cars get replaced again. They get replaced every like 15 or so years, so we're looking at a time where if you are closing it for an extended period of time, I would be more concerned if they don't replace the cars, because that's 2 years of the ride being shut. You're still using cars that have operated for 15 years that are almost part of the problem. So I would be really concerned if they didn't replace the cars. But hey, you know, the film is coming out in 2025. That's something I've stated on the social media pages. While it's unfortunate, you know, all I can say is, you know, I'm going to make the film as best as possible. And that brings us on to the next section of this little discussion, of this little video, and that's the different cuts of the film. Now, I mentioned briefly in that Instagram and Facebook and Twitter post that there might be a chance to release different cuts in the future. What this now has come to in my mind is there will be three different cuts of Tolbert. There will be the original, not the original, but a cut of the film that was submitted as my college project, where there are screens, there are images that say please skip to a certain section, but only those images are only in sections like Wicker Man and Oblivion, where there is missing footage, but there is a mostly finished section, but there is missing footage towards the end. There's that version. There is the new, which I class as the 2023 cut, because that was made in 2023. There'll be the 2024 cut, which I'm currently working on now, which will be a brand new, fresh edit of the pre-existing footage that already exists that I shot last year, with no additional footage, without those kind of cards, so the music will be cut a little bit shorter for a couple of the rides. Brand new, fresh edits, new visuals, new additional music that has been released since the original cut, so that's primarily for Curse at Altar Manor, but also expanding the Nemesis section, obviously not including the new Reborn stuff, but will be, you know, additional music for Curse of Altar Manor, essentially, as well as fresh edits, like I said, and a fresh look for the film, at least the current version of the film, where they'll be differently coloured and things like that. And then there'll be the final 2025 cut, as I like to call it, or the final cut, which will be a brand new, freshly shot version of the film, which could get any longer or any shorter, and that version, that we'll point out now, the 2024 version will include the Retro Squad, but it will not include Subterra, because I have not got any existing footage of Subterra. It obviously will not include Spinball, it will not include Skyride, but it will include everything else that operated at the park, including the Retro Squad, because it's a re-edit of the current footage. But when it comes to the 2025 version, it will not include the Retro Squad, and it will not include any of the pre-existing footage. Like I said, it will be completely reshot from the ground up, everything from the ground up, so it is what will be there in 2025. However, there was one small snag to the 2025 edit, and that is that because I would really love to capture Nemesis Reborn in its opening debut year for the film, I am hopefully making a family trip up to Haunted Towers with a couple of members of my family, just for, you know, a family get together, that kind of thing. And I do plan to shoot 3 to 4 minutes of Nemesis Reborn footage on that day. So there will be some footage of the 2025 version that will have been shot in 2024, but it won't be included in the 2024 edit, if that makes sense. Just to capture Nemesis Reborn in its newest state, when it could be in a very different state when it comes to next year. I'm not saying it will be, but you know, it's fresh, it's brand new, it's been open for literally like 4 days. So obviously it's not going to be anytime soon, that shoot, but that is something I've decided that I will do. So yeah, like I said, there'll be 3 versions of the film. The 2023 cut, which is a pre-existing cut, already done, already on YouTube and unlisted link. When that will release, I couldn't tell you. There'll be the 2024 edit of the film, which is currently in the editing process, in post-production. Now, I will admit that that version of the film started off as a complete rejig of the whole thing, and it was going to morph into this other cut that is never going to exist, where it would be a re-edit of the older footage, and including footage of Nemesis Reborn, Nemesis Subterra, blah, 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 Skyride, Spirit War, blah, blah, blah. And that morphed, mixed, crazy abomination version of the film is never going to happen. As much as someone might say, oh, that might be cool to mix and match them together to make the ultimate thing, I highly doubt I'll ever do that, because it's just, it seems like it would extend the film to like 3 hours. So if you want like a mega 3 hour cut that includes all the old footage, all the new footage matched together, there'll be an issue with music lengths and additional tracks, but I'm sure I could probably do it if I wanted to, but that will be in a couple of years when I have the time to spare. At the moment, I cannot speculate on when the 2023 cut will be released. It could be within a couple of weeks, it could be much further down the line. I would like to say that I'll probably be drop it on Monday the 25th of March, just because I feel like, you know, make it public then, that might be fun. So look out for that possibly dropping then. I'll make a post about that. But yeah, I really hope that you've enjoyed following the progress of Talbot, where I've posted it, where I've mentioned it, and the teasers and trailers that have come out. I'm not going to do any more like teasers or trailers for this version of the film, so you'll just get a drop of this version of the film and then the 2024 edit before the end of this year. And I'll post on social media, but there'll be no trailers for that one. There will be a new trailer when I'm doing the whole new shoot next year. But yeah, it's been a great passion of mine to be making this film. It's not a, you know, per se normal kind of film, because there's no dialogue. It's a very experimental piece. And as I described it in a lot of my coursework stuff, it's to try and create the ultimate audio-visual experience of Wharton Towers without having to leave your home. An ultimate tour of Wharton Towers. If you've seen the version that exists on YouTube Unlisted, you know that there's a very specific structure to the film, with a very specific flow of areas to round, starting with the monorail, and then that would take you to Tower Street, following round from Mutiny Bay, through Katanga Canyon, up through Gloomy Wood to Forbidden Valley. And then at that point, the Skyride would be inserted to sort of say, oh, you're taking the Skyride from, obviously it would include footage of Skyride from all of the parks, but be inserted there to say, oh, you're taking the Skyride from Forbidden Valley to Dark Forest. Then you'd have Dark Forest with Rita and 13 moving through to Wild Elms World, Cloud Cuckoo Cars, moving down to Hex, then moving to X Sector with those rides, moving to Spinball Whizzer, and then culminating at the Splash Landings Hotel, and finally culminating with the final section of the film being the Wharton Towers Hotel. The Splash Landings Hotel obviously would include the water park. So it'll be your complete full experience of Wharton Towers, with really nice effects and visuals to go with all the different rides. And I will mention another thing about the 2025 version, and also the 2024 version, is that the 2023 cut that you know, will be released shortly, heavily focuses more on the music side of things opposed to the actual sound mix of the rides. Of the 2024 and 2025 versions will try and combine the ride sounds and music to make it the ultimate in terms of sensory experience of hearing the rides, hearing the music in the same fashion. So I hope you've enjoyed this little update on Talbot. I hope to be able to give you more information soon. Look out for the 2023 cut and 2024 cuts by the end of this year. And I cannot wait to show you the final 2025 version of the film when that comes about. Thank you so much for listening, watching. Have a great day. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Bye-bye for now. We'll be right back.